Hi, I'm Balan Madhavan. As a wildlife photographer, I have traveled across the world. Almost all wildlife photographers travel to different parts of the country or even outside the country, looking for exotic species. If you want to shoot the cheetah, obviously you need to go to Africa. If you want to shoot penguins, you need to go to South America or Antarctica. Likewise, in my opinion, if you want to see and take pictures of dolphins, Sri Lankan coast is the best place in the whole world. The coast of Sri Lanka, which is facing India, that's the western coast of Sri Lanka, is one of the best marine reserves where you can see hundreds of dolphins. Sometimes a single pod of dolphins will have more than 6,000 individuals. So this is possible in Sri Lankan coast. There is a small place called Kalpitiya, where if you go there, they'll take you on small fiberglass boats into the ocean, and maybe like 6 or 7 kilometers into the ocean, you'll come across these huge pods of dolphins. They'll be just jumping all around you. They are very fast, very active, and you need to have a set of skills to capture the peak of the action. So what are the things that are required to capture action? We are not discussing about underwater photography here. That's a different school altogether, okay? We are talking about how to capture a marine mammal, the dolphin, when it's above the water. But being playful, they jump a lot. Especially this particular species of dolphin that I'm showing you, they are called the spinner dolphins because they jump into the air and spin and they again fall back. But where they are going to take off and which part of the water they are going to take off and jump, you have no clue. Which means that you need to have very fast reflexes. And also, there are a few challenges that you'll be facing. Number one, you are sitting inside a fiberglass boat. The sea has got swell, it is rolling. Along with that, the boat is also moving and it is also rocking on different sides. So when you are shooting, always ensure that the horizon in the background remains horizontal. Because when the boat is rolling like that, it's quite natural that your camera also get tilted. And when finally the picture comes out, you will have an ocean line which is like a diagonal, which will spoil the picture. So always check the horizon whether it is remaining horizontal. Also, we need high shutter speeds and also depth of field. It's practically impossible to shoot a dolphin with an aperture of 2.8. We need to show the part of the ocean, the habitat as well. So unless we maintain the aperture at least anywhere between 8 and 11, the depth of field will not be enough. So maintain 8 or 11 aperture, then we need high shutter speed for multiple reasons. Number one, the dolphin is jumping or dolphin is swimming very fast. And also the boat is creating all kind of movement. So in order to compensate all these complex movements, maintain a shutter speed of at least 1 by 1250 or preferably 2000 shutter speed. So increase the ISO and practice. Always maintain the horizon horizontally and you need to have fast reflexes. Keep your lens on continuous mode autofocus and keep tracking the school of dolphins. That's very important because once they start coming out and moving fast, maintain the dolphins within your frame, and the moment suddenly one dolphin takes off from the water, be ready. keep the shutter in continuous mode so that you get multiple shots with every click. So these are the things you need to understand. But if at all you are able to travel with dolphins, keep all this in your mind and make good pictures. Thank you.